Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today let's look at the final part of the line by line explanation of the chapter The Ailing Planet from class 11 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, consider subscribing. You can listen to the explanations of chapters from classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. So we were talking about the rise in population. It took mankind more than a million years to reach the first billion. So according to the narrator, it took million years for the population to reach 1 billion. That was the world population around the year 1800. By the year 1900, a second billion was added. So again by the next 100 years, there was one more billion. And by 1900, the population was 2 billion. And the 20th century has added another 3.7 billion. So when it became the 20th century, another 3.7 billion was added, and the current, and at that time during the 20th century, the population was 5.7 billion. But now during 2019, the current population is 7.7 million. So you can see how fast the population is increasing. Every 4 days, the world population increases by 1 million. So according to the current estimate, the narrator says that about 1 million of people, the amount of population is rising by 1 million per 4 days. Fertility falls as incomes rise, education spreads and health improves. So he says that the fertility falls, that means the ability to produce offsprings becomes lesser as education spreads and health improves, because people become more aware, they understand the value of this population increase and they know what are the dangers it causes, and so the amount of children produced will be less. This development is the best contraceptive. Contraceptive is nothing but the device that stops population increase. So he says that once development is there, there will be no increase in population as people become aware of the dangers of population increase. But development itself may be not possible if the present increase in number continues. So if the same number of population increase continues, the narrator says that development is not possible, because if more and more people keep increasing or coming on to this earth, it will be very difficult for the development to take place. So as the population increases, the earth itself will find it very difficult, because it will not be able to provide all the resources. The rich get richer and the poor beget children, which condemns them to remain poor. So the rich people only become richer and the poor become poor and they get more children, because they are not aware of the importance of population control, or they have no awareness about the development that is around. So that's why there is always increase in population among the poor people. More children does not mean more workers, merely more people without work. So when we have more children, it does not mean that we have more people to work. It simply means that we have more people without any work. It is not suggested that human beings be treated like cattle and compulsorily be sterilized. So we cannot even treat all these human beings like cattle and be sterilized, because as the poor people grow in number, they do not know the meaning of development and they just go on producing children and more children. So they cannot be treated like cattle and be asked to stop producing children or compulsorily be sterilized, or their ability to produce children be removed by force. But there is no alternative to voluntary family planning without introducing an element of coercion. So according to the narrator, he says that more and more people, because they do not know the meaning of development, they may not come voluntarily for family planning. So at certain times it becomes necessary for introducing by force and asking people to get sterilized or stop producing more children. The choice is really between the two, control of population and perpetuation of poverty. So the narrator says that there is only choice between these two factors. What are these two? One is control of population and the other one is continuation of poverty indefinitely. So the best alternative will be control of population, which will help us to increase or develop our own country. The population of India is estimated to be 920 million today, more than the entire populations of Africa and South America put together. So you can see how big the population of India is. You can put two countries or two continents together and it is much bigger than that. No one familiar with the conditions in India would doubt the hope of the people would die in their hungry hutments unless population control is given the topmost priority. So everybody who knows about the conditions in India would only say that the most important thing to be done at the moment is population control. So only if population control is done, people in the poor hutments will have some hope for the future. So the most important thing that has to be done right now is population control, which has to be given the topmost priority or the supreme importance. For the first time in human history, we see a transcending concern, the survival not just of the people but of the planet. So for the first time we see that the people have a transcending concern, that means a concern that is beyond boundaries. Not only the people think about their own country, but they think about the whole planet as a whole. So they think that the planet itself is very important other than one's own country itself. We have begun to take a holistic view of the very basis of our existence. So the people have become aware and they have begun to take a holistic view about their existence itself. They know that everything is interdependent on each other. So they have to take care about the needs and concerns of all the things, about the environment, about the ecosystem, about all the four biospheres that was spoken before. Everything should be taken care of. The environmental problem does not necessarily sign our demise. It is our passport for the future. So when we have known that there is a problem in the environment, it does not show that the whole planet is going to be destroyed. But then it has given us an understanding that we have to do something about it, and that is the passport for our future. It gives us a way to take care of the planet and save ourselves and save the planet for the future generations. The emerging new world vision has ushered in the era of responsibility. So the emerging new world vision, what is this new world vision? That our whole planet is in danger and then we have to control our population, etc. So we have become aware of all these problems that the whole planet is facing or the whole mankind is facing. So this has ushered in the era of responsibility. So it has brought in a time when man is going to be responsible and take all the responsibility on himself to take care of the planet for the future and give a safe and sound planet for the future generations. It is a holistic view and ecological view, seeing the world as an integrated whole rather than a dissociated collection of parts. Now that we have all understood the problems that we are facing, we all have started having a holistic view or an ecological view. That means taking the world as one rather than considering it as parts of different countries or whatever. So whatever we are trying to do should be for the improvement of the whole world itself or for the whole planet itself, instead of taking the development by parts. Industry has a most crucial role to play in this new era of responsibility. So according to the narrator, he says that the industries have a great role to play during this era of responsibility. What a transformation would be effected if more businessmen share the view of the chairman of DuPont, Mr. Edgar S. Wooland, who 5 years ago declared himself to be the company's chief environmental officer. So the narrator says that the industry has a great role to play, and people like the chairman of DuPont considered himself or declared himself the chief environmental officer because he was more concerned about the environment and wanted to safeguard the planet itself. He said, "Our continued existence as a leading manufacturer requires that we excel in environmental performance." So he says that if they had to continuously be the leading manufacturer, they have to also excel in environmental performance. That means they have to take care of the environment also along with their manufacturing. That means whatever work they do, whatever they manufacture, they have to take care that the environment is not harmed in any way at all. Of all the statements made by Margaret Thatcher during the years of her prime ministership, none has passed so decisively into the current coin of English usage as her felicitous words. So Margaret Thatcher, the prime minister, had made a lot of statements when she was a prime minister, but this statement was more welcome because it was concerned with the safeguarding of the planet. No generation has a freehold on this earth. So according to Mrs. Margaret Thatcher, she says that no generation can say that this earth belongs to them. All we have is a life tenancy. So she says that we all are only tenants on this earth with a full repairing lease. That means when we vacate this place, we are supposed to repair and return our services for having this beautiful earth. So when we have to leave the place, we have to leave it back in the same condition that we had taken it from. So that means all the damages that we have done should be repaired. In the words of Mr. Lester Brown, we have not inherited this from our forefathers. So he says that we have not inherited this property as our own, and we cannot do whatever we wish. We cannot destroy it. So we have actually borrowed it from our children. So this property does not belong to us. We have actually borrowed it from our children. So when we have borrowed something, we should also return it in the same condition. So the best thing is we have to give it to them in the best possible manner by repairing all its damages so that the planet Earth is complete with its natural resources for the future generations to enjoy. I hope you liked today's video. For more interesting videos, do subscribe to my CBSE English teacher. Do like, share, and give your valuable comments below. Thank you for watching.